SCP-3444-2 Origins. SCP-3444-2 opens onto a predominantly rural landscape. A single building will be present somewhere close to SCP-3444-2. Beyond this, the landscape appears to stretch on indefinitely, with little or no variation. Located within the building will be SCP-3444-9-A, ordinarily a genetic copy of one of the subject's parents. The subject will feel compelled to enter the building, converse briefly with SCP-3444-9-A, and then return to SCP-3444-1. SCP-3444-9-A will admonish the subject for failing to live up to their duties at home, and encourage them to follow a traditional career path within the local community, despite the apparent lack of one within the locale. SCP-3444-9-A will also frequently disparage the subject's aspirations for the future. Please consult Experiment Log 3444-5 for more information. Experiment Log, SCP-3444-5, Section 2. Subject, D-3150, a male from Lancashire, UK, convicted of arson. D-3150 was a failed ska musician who, having fallen into poverty, was paid by a local gangster to burn down the homes of several individuals indebted to him. Begin log.
All right, D-3150, please exit the station.
Sure. Fine by me.
D-3150 leaves SCP-3444-2. The landscape appears to be a Lancastrian livestock farm, with a small cottage present about 500 meters away. D-3150 suddenly stops, apparently startled.
D-3150, is everything all right?
Yeah, it's just... this looks exactly like home. Those hills are just like those next to Mum's old farm. Where the hell am I? I was in America someplace.
Please relax, D-3150. Walk towards the cottage.
Sure. It'd be nice to see somewhere homely again.
D-3150 walks toward the cottage. After 15 minutes without interruption, he reaches the door. The cottage is small and made of stone, like many such cottages in the northwest of England.
Funny, really. Never thought I'd be in part of this world again, after I left for the city.
Just enter the cottage, please.
Yeah, okay.
D-3150 enters the cottage. It is furnished in a style reminiscent of 1970s England, although it is only the size of a single room. In a rocking chair in the center of the cottage sits SCP-3444-9-A, apparently in the form of D-3150's mother.
Mum? What are you doing here? What is this?
Oh, it's you, is it? Out making trouble again? You should be helping me here.
Mum, you died. You're dead. You died years ago.
I did no such thing. I've been here, as you should have been. Honestly, with all your dreams of going to the city, there's cows to milk. Go and milk them.
But Mum, I can do that later. There's so much that we... I'm sorry, Mum. I'm sorry about everything.
Oh, hush your noise. Go and milk the cows. We're not going to make ends meet sitting here doing nothing. Go on with you.
You never got me, did you, Mum? I had dreams. I had ambitions. Instead, I was stuck here, milking your cows. Until finally, I couldn't take it anymore. What kind of man did he expect me to grow up into when all I got from you was apathy?
You are a rude and insolent child. I raised you. I taught you how to farm. I gave you nothing but love and affection, boy. Look how you've turned out. Go and milk the cows. It's all you're good for.
Yes, Mum. I'll go now.
D-3150 leaves the cottage, and begins walking back to SCP-3444-2.
D-3150, where are you going? We had more questions we wish to ask the instant.
Yeah, I know. Good behavior and everything, but this feels right, you know? I've got to get away here. There's stuff that I want to do in Manchester. That's where things are really happening, you know? It's just a few miles on train.
End log. Summary of subsequent silver events. At SCP-3444-3, Bright Lights, the station opened onto a recreation of 1980s Manchester, but one which appeared to be significantly more prosperous and well-maintained than Manchester was during that period. D-3150 walked through several record shops before returning to SCP-3444-3. At SCP-3444-4, Hardship, the station opened onto a recreation of a 1980s slum in Manchester. D-3150 D3150 gave an impassioned soliloquy about the difficulties of working at a laundromat when he wanted to become a renowned ska musician. At SCP-3444-5, First Sight, the station opened onto a discotheque. The SCP-3444-9-B instance was a female ska musician in her mid-30s. D3150 and SCP-3444-9-B engaged in dancing for most of the duration of the Silver event. At SCP-3444-6, Big Break, the station opened onto the office of a prominent record manager who agreed to finance D3150's ska record. At SCP-3444-7, Love, the station opened onto a rundown motel on the outskirts of Manchester. SCP-3444-9-B gave an impassioned soliloquy about how she was being forced to leave Manchester. D3150 then assured her that he would look after her. The two then checked into the motel before engaging in sexual intercourse. At SCP-3444-8, Climax, the station opened onto the same version of Manchester as seen outside SCP-3444-3. D3150, SCP-3444-9-B, and a variety of SCP-3444-9 instances apparently representing D3150's friends visited a variety of bars and clubs, imbibing several units of alcohol while there. D3150 then returned to SCP-3444-8. D3150's sobriety was immediately restored upon entering the station. At SCP-3444's second manifestation, Wake Up, ska music could be heard before D3150 left the station. Note, D3150 has subsequently been released and become a successful ska musician, headlining a musical group called Ska Ska Land.